I'm sorry.
No.
Some of them cute or whatever. The or whatever is the part. But I'm just out here to do my little business, girl, and get the fuck. So they let me check in early for $50. That's bad. That's bad. I'm hungry now. Surprised, right? Like, who's shaky, hungry? What the fuck? So I'm gonna unpack briefly. But then I'm actually going to, so I need to go to the UPS store and bring some stuff, which is basically like stuff that I'm gonna ship to my house. Cause I'm tired of lugging it around. And so, but also too, when I go home Monday, I have a five-hour layover in Dallas. So I'm gonna probably try to go see Zora and Dylan in that 5 hours, cause you can't leave the airport. You gotta just come back, you gotta go through security again. So instead of having like my bag and my carry-on, I'm going to put, why my mom? Oh yeah, girl. That's crack AMO. That's crack AMO right there. That's crack AMO. That was crack AMO. Bitch, y'all talk about Cocarina, bitch. How do you feel about Andrew Caldwell assisting desist? Cease and desists are not mandatory, they're optional. You don't have to follow cease and desist. That cease and desist is just you putting your own notice. So if she keep playing with him, or she keeps putting his name and stuff, he will have the ability to sue. Well, you have the ability to sue anyway. You can sue anybody for anything at any time, except like a sitting president of the United States, or his motion pursuant to the 10th Amendment, 11th or 13th, one of the 13th Amendments into slavery. 10th? You can sue anybody for any time for any reason. Meaning you have the right as a person to seek redress of grievances through the court system. That's what the court system is. It's supposed to be access to anybody, meaning that, whatever. So legally speaking, and I'm not a lawyer, of course, what do I feel about Andrew Caldwell's cease and desist letter? It's foolish. He can cease and desist and ask her to stop talking about him, but as long as she's not defaming his character, in the sense of this video being viral, that's not defaming his character. First, him saying he don't like her or something like that, that's not, she, as far as Super Saiyan saying, oh, I don't like Andrew Caldwell, he ugly, or whatever, that's, of course, opinion. Him calling her calling him names is also freedom of speech, you have the right. Defaming character, for defamation, it has to be, you're saying like this, saying, oh, Andrew Caldwell got AIDS. And going with that to where it's damaging his character, but her saying the opinion, so that's like, you can say your opinion about anybody. You can say your opinion about anybody. Now, also with defamation is this too, and so vice this. So like, I can say like, Stacey and Gemini has herpes, but that's not defaming his character because there is court documentation that backs that up. So with that, I'm good in the clear. I can't defame your character when something is public information. So in the case of that, like that's for instance, Super Saiyan would have to say, Super Saiyan would have to say, oh, Andrew Caldwell got AIDS, and then he would have to prove that he did have AIDS, and her habitually doing it would, after the cease and desist ever, would be defamation of character, and that'd be suable. And that'd be like, he'd probably win. However, I never heard her say that. I'm just giving you an example of how that would be. Cease and desist is optional. She don't have to follow it. If she chooses not to follow it, she does open herself up for risk of a lawsuit, but the lawsuit got to be defamation. The only other case of that is libel. Libel is, my habitual talking about you is making you lose business. For example, libel is, okay, Super Saiyan talking about like, fuck Andrew Caldwell, and he's not getting booked or something because of the, oh, I don't want to book you now because Super Saiyan was talking about you. Well, that might be liable. They make Super Saiyan liable for the, not liable, but libel, L-I-B-E-L. And that goes into something completely different. So in the case of this, it's like Andrew Caldwell just jumping up the wrong tree. You can't stop somebody's opinion. People exercise First Amendment rights to freedom of speech, freedom of expression, and not liking somebody or thinking that they're ugly is definitely a matter of opinion. And also, too, under that First Amendment, you have the right to comedic expressions for parody. So, for example, that's how I could talk about them hoes like a dog, and they really can't do nothing because what I constitute, well, I'm protected under the Fifth Amendment, freedom of speech, freedom of press, freedom of expression. Also, the act where I can for comedic expression, like I'm making fun of them. It's like nobody takes it seriously. And so this is where they fuck themselves all the time because they like to showboat. If they show, oh, my sales are down, they could get me to shut up tomorrow. Like if they show, oh, my sales are down because of what Shaky do, then that will put me in there. But by them every time I want to showboat, like boom, I make more sales. But listen, basically I can slick side through them. In a sense, okay, now this is weird, but it's like a, okay, I'm not gonna play on my cards, but if you're constantly showing you're getting more stuff even though I'm talking about you, then your court cases are really stupid. It's really moot, like you get more attention. So if soup is stupid, this is what all she has to do to defeat Andrew Caldwell in any sense of the case. Andrew Caldwell probably would say, I would consider him a public figure to say that he is somebody who basically is an influencer. And so all I would do was screenshot his followers before and then have a screenshot of his followers after and be like, okay, this is what his followers was on this date, this is what his followers was on that date, and they went up, boom. This is what his numbers was doing on this date, this is what his numbers was doing on that date, boom, they went up. This is what, so I always, every time I do something against Stupid Saint or of Judy now, I screenshot what they do. Like she got a million followers, right? And she got a picture over there that was up for 24 hours and got like 30 comments. And so, bitch, a million followers and 30 comments. So I screenshot that as my backup plan. Now, if I'm going to talk about her next Monday, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to show what the comments is on Monday. And so as long as they up, I'm really helping you, bitch. And so I'm really protecting myself so I can talk about you like I want, but actually I can show that you're getting more engagement as an influencer because of that. So all Stupid would have to do in that case is screenshot before and after, showing that you're getting more engagement because of this. And as an influencer, engagement is what drives your traffic, which allows you to be successful as an engager. So I'm making you more successful by talking about you, not detrimenting you. He would have to prove. And so the burden of proof is always on the people that is suing, not the person being sued. The person being sued doesn't have to prove that they were wrong. They don't have to prove that they were right. They just have to defend that they were not wrong. In the case of the plaintiff, the person who's suing, you have to prove unequivocally that the person wronged you. So Andrew Caldwell's cease and desist letter is basically nothing. It's basically him saying, listen, I see what you're doing. I don't like it. Could you please stop before I try to sue you? At the end of the day. That's all it is. Now, what is a lawsuit? Not a bitch ass thing. A lawsuit is just you saying to court you think this person is wrong and saying, and anybody could sue anybody for anything at any time for any reason. So in the case of that, it's really nothing. The system, this is Stupid Saint don't have to do a bitch ass thing. She could talk about him if she want. Any competent lawyer say that she has a lot of freedoms and protections against that. That's not going to, do she want to fight a lawsuit? That's the question. Now she's too stupid to do it by herself. But so obviously, in the case of me, bitch, I defend that by myself, bitch. But in her case, she would have to pay a lawyer. So is it worth her paying a lawyer? Probably. Because, okay, I don't believe she does. Now, no person in their right mind for 2 seconds thinks that she makes all that money that she alleges she makes in the case. Because you just too, okay, first of all, the nigga you with don't have curtains. So that's number one. Okay, so that's just number one. The nigga that you with, he don't have curtains. So the fact that you didn't even buy him no curtains lets me know that you would, like, for $300,000, you make $300,000 off of Andrew Caldwell. See, that's the thing. She got to be careful for. That's what she got to be careful for. Okay? See, because his suit, instead of being cease and desist, he shouldn't have did that. He should have filed suit to show, look, because of me and her ridicule of me, she's making sales. And I need to get a piece of that. That's what he could sue her for. That's what he could sue her for. It's not the fact, like, you know, it's like, you're not making any sales prior. You actually give me the proof you need because you're showing that boom, boom, boom. You are You was making no sales. You had no traffic. And all of a sudden you jump up to $300,000. And the only differentiation between then and now is the fact that you ridiculed me. That's his argument. Oh, bye, Goro. You're doing too much. Somebody just asked me. It's not that I'm talking about them. Just somebody asked the question. What I thought about it. I'm passing who the fuck I think. I'm a blogger. The fuck? Is that... So am I saying something... Okay, I called her stupid, but I call her stupid all the time. So what... So listen, I'm not spilling tea, and I'm not really saying nothing negative about nobody. In a sense, I'm just telling... I'm really... Both of them stupid, if you ask me. No shame. Somebody asked me what I thought. I'm just passing my opinion. You know what? I'm going to talk to y'all later. I love y'all. I love, see, people getting their fucking feelings and just pisses me the fuck off just that fucking fast about the dumbest shit. Like, I'm not really talking, like, so you're saying I'm talking about them, but I'm not really talking about them. I'm talking about the fucking situation. That's the fuck first. And second, somebody just asked about the situation, and I'm really telling you from both motherfucking sides what the fuck is wrong, what the fuck it is. But at the same fucking time, now, as far as me, like, you talking about, like, bitch, I talk about what the fuck I want. It's not that fucking serious. People getting in their fucking feelings too fucking much about the dumbest fucking shit. That pisses me the fuck off. That's what make me leave these mother... See, these motherfucking apps will get a bitch motherfucking girl, just that fucking quick. Like, we was really having a really, like, a real good conversation. It wasn't really nothing bad about either one of them, really. We know they both stupid, bitch. I mean, I call both of them stupid on the daily, and that's obvious. It's not like I'm, oh, girl, blah, blah, blah. It's not even that. We was really having an intelligent conversation about what the fuck was going on in with both of their situation. So at the end of the day, they both got some advice from a bitch who been sued and sued, bitch. So who, bitch, and not that I'm a lawyer or nothing, but bitch, at the end of the day, I wasn't saying nothing negative. So at the end of the day, yes, we were starting 2020. That's, look, say, 2021, I can't do IG. This shit pissing me the fuck off. Like, at the end of the day, bitches really doing too fucking much on this bitch. And then there be bitches in the comments with no picture, no profile, no nothing, scared to stand on a motherfucking comment they say. Bitch, I stand on every fucking thing I say. At the end of the day, listen, y'all, 2021, y'all be blessed. I love y'all so much. Y'all have a nice day.